cancer medicine is more and more geared towards personalized approaches. And so we always think, how will this eventually impact our patients? My name is Dr. Markus Bredel, and I'm a senior scientist in the O'Neill Comprehensive Cancer Center. I've been interested and fascinated by the brain ever since I can remember. And so brain tumors are right at the crossroad of those two interests, brain and cancer. Diffuse gliomas is kind of an umbrella term for a group of brain tumors, which are actually the most frequent ones. And I see in clinic on a daily basis how those tumors impact my patients very substantially. And so the hope is that with the research that we're doing, that we can improve our understanding of those tumors and then translate this into advanced therapies. So this is the part of the lab where we're doing our DNA and bacterial work. This is Aran, he's doing a prep right now.
Yeah, I'm Aran Marathi. I'm a PhD candidate here. I'm in my fourth year now. Yeah, so we have two main projects. That one is mine, and then the other is for NF-kappa-B, which is also a different tumor suppressor. And basically a tumor suppressor is just like a protein or gene that is meant to, you know, kind of prevent cancer from forming.
We have identified a genetic marker in diffuse gliomas, which helps us to better understand what propels those tumors biologically, and also allows us to better predict how those tumors do for our patients, so how they behave clinically, and to improve treatments for our patients. And then this is the bay where we do most of the protein work. So you see Nicholas and Rajni doing some work at this point.
Yeah, my name is Rajani Rasmundari, and I'm a lab manager. I train newcomers, you know, I do all the lab, take care of equipments, order supplies. Also the ongoing project, I do research. So if there is a huge amount of anything that need to be purchased, I go through them. So I take care of the lab.
So sometimes we have a hypothesis based on a basic model that we pursue in the laboratory. We will do research, we will genetically edit and modify those cells to see what happens. Or we might take the opposite way. We might characterize something in patient materials and find a certain genetic change in the tumor materials, and then take that genetic change into the laboratory.
My name is Nicholas Johnson. I'm a graduate research assistant in the DICER fellowship program. So we focus on tumor suppressants in glioblastoma, one of the most common, most detrimental brain cancers. This work is very translational. So the stuff we do in lab here can be correlated back to clinic.
Gliomas, or brain tumors in general, are understudied. And I think this is because of the comparatively low incidence and rate of occurrence compared to some of the other cancers. They are less researched, they're less funded. I think we need to remember, though, how profoundly those tumors impact our patients, not only in terms of life expectancy, but also in terms of the quality of their life, as well as the life of the families that are affected. Our patients are an endless source of inspiration because they're the ones who are really affected by this most. And that motivates me not only being the best possible physician for them in the clinic, but also to pursue research, as slow and frustrating as it sometimes is, to hopefully make a difference for our patients down the road.